Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to my channel, my dear friends. My name is Abhilash and I'm a trader next door. In this video, I'll be analyzing the chart of GBP USD, British Pound US Dollar. So if you're watching my videos for the first time, then please subscribe to my channel for regular market analysis and do check out the Forex analysis playlist on my YouTube channel for the analysis of other pairs like Euro USD, Gold USD, USD JPY and many more. So let's get started. So this is the photo chart of GBP USD in front of us right now, and as you can see that I have got many lines here drawn on the chart, and to be honest I prefer to keep my chart clean. But in the chart of GBP USD that thing is not that possible because things are a little bit complicated, and to be honest I am avoiding GBP USD for quite some time. So anyways, there are many of you who love to trade on GBP USD, and so let's try to understand what is going on in the chart of GBP USD and what are the trading opportunities or can be the trading opportunities on this chart. Let's find out. So first of all, let me discuss about this level. Okay, this is the this is standing at the top. Okay, this is the supreme resistance on the chart of GBP USD. But right now you can see that the current market price is far away, so this level is not that required. Okay. And if you just focus at this particular portion of the chart here, then 1.3600 is the most important support for GBP USD, because whenever market saw heavy sell-off or whenever market faced heavy selling pressure, 1.3600 was the level that provided support to the market, and as a result 1.3600 is the most important support for GBP USD. So apart from this resistance level, we also have 1.3750 to 1.3780 as a resistance zone. This was previously the support for the GBP USD, and this level has been acting as a very strong support for the last couple of months. But when market saw or witnessed this selling, the same level is now acting as a resistance for the market, because we all know that support becomes resistance and resistances become support in the market. And right now 1.3750 to 1.3780, this level is the resistance for the market. Clear? So this is the resistance and 1.3600 is the support for the market. But right now you can see that market is trading in the middle, and surprisingly 1.3713, this level is kind of acting as a resistance for the market. Or market, you can see that market is struggling. Okay, market is struggling near this level also, but still we cannot consider this as a strong resistance or any resistance right now, because it is too early right now. So considering the importance of this weekly resistance level and this support level, the strategy is simple. First and foremost, listen to me. Okay, if market goes up and reverses from the resistance level, we can definitely short the market. If we see selling pressure from above, if we see market reversing from this particular level, definitely we can go for a sell on GBP USD. On the other hand, we can easily go for a buy if market bounces from 1.3600. But right now you can see that market is in the middle. Market is in the middle. Therefore we do not have any proper answer whether we should short the market here or not, because see, previously market did test the level and market reversed, but right now market is going up. We do not have the clarity about this level right now, this particular level. So for proper clarification, what we can do is that we can go to the 1 hour chart of GBP USD once, and if I draw the Fibonacci levels here. Generally I do not use Fibonacci much, but here I can see that Fibonacci levels are working good. See, the support from the support at the 1.3600 is intact. The weekly resistance is also intact, and here you can see that this level was the Fibonacci 23.6% retracement level, and the same level is now acting as a resistance. Hilarious. Anyways, what I'm saying is that in case market reverses also from this particular level, do not short the market, because see, your main goal is to earn money, not to risk your hard-earned money on a chart that you do not understand. If market reverses from the Fibonacci level of 61.8%, or if market if market reverses from the Fibonacci level of 61.8%, or if market reverses from the 50% retracement level, then you can think about buying. But this is not the ideal position to short the market if market reverses also. So my dear friend, do not make the mistake, do not risk your hard-earned money on a chart that you do not understand. And most importantly, okay, always use proper risk management and stop loss. So if market comes down, okay, if market comes down and bounces from here, you can go for a buy, because this is your Fibonacci retracement level, and yes, you can hope that market will be bouncing. Okay, but on the other hand, the fact remains the same that weekly resistance is still the best resistance for shorting the market, and 1.3600 is the best level for going for a buy in the market. Okay, and the rest of the decision is totally up to you. And if you go to the forex sentiment meter here, you can see that 43% retail traders have taken short position and 56% retail traders have taken long position. So 56% retail traders are thinking the market will be going up, and 43% thinking market will be going down. So we do not have any proper picture from the sentiment on retail traders as well. So it is kind of critical here. Okay. Anyways, trade with proper analysis and trade with proper reasoning. My dear friends, do not take any impulsive trade and do not short the market here, because that can be quite risky. Short the market at the resistance, or go for buy at this Fibonacci retracement level, or only go for buy at 1.3600. That's it. Bye bye, take care, see you tomorrow.